Good morning, everybody. I'm Raquel from HUMSS 11A, and today I'm gonna be taking you through a chill day in my life. Today I woke up at 7 a.m., which is pretty early for me. This is great because I have been quite stressed lately and I have been sleeping at around 1 to 2 a.m. Now, before we begin, what is stress? Stress is the body's reaction to pressure or a challenging event. It is the feeling of being overwhelmed or unable to cope with pressure. When I am under stress, I find it difficult to do even the simplest of tasks, like getting out of bed. Turns out, stress manifests itself in physical and mental symptoms. Its physical symptoms include tiredness, body pains, high blood pressure, digestive problems, and more. Meanwhile, emotional and mental symptoms include anxiety, irritability, depression, and panic attacks. After taking a bath, I start my day by making a nutritious breakfast. Today, I'm having matcha oatmeal with banana and kiwi. It's important to have a nourishing breakfast like oatmeal and fruit as it fuels you with energy and lowers the risk of disease. Also, did you know that stress increases the risk of conditions like heart disease, Alzheimer's disease, and depression? That's why stress management is essential to our overall health and well-being.
Hello, so it's currently 8:45 a.m. and I just finished having my breakfast. It's been a while since I was able to sit down, eat, and enjoy my breakfast, so I feel really refreshed right now. But before I move on to the next thing on my agenda today, I just want to share with you guys something I learned about stress management. So I learned that there are two ways we typically cope with stress. The first way is avoidant coping. Avoidant coping is a form of coping in which a person distracts themselves and diverts their attention away from the stress to avoid the difficulties their stressor presents. So this could go like, I have a bunch of deadlines due next week and I haven't started on any of them, so I'll just go and watch Netflix. Clearly, this is a maladaptive way of coping, but most of us are guilty of it simply because it is more convenient. Although avoidant coping can relieve stress in the short term, avoidant coping comes at a cost. Because instead of eliminating your stressor and managing it now, you are just ignoring it to deal with at a later time. The second type of coping is active coping. Active coping involves an awareness of the problem or stressor, and conscious efforts are made to reduce or eliminate the stress or its root cause. Active coping is characterized by solving a problem through appropriately targeted behavior and embracing responsibility for a situation using one's available internal resources. Now, I have been making a conscious effort to practice active coping more often, and it has really changed my outlook on stress. Let's go back to the day in my life where I shall be sharing with you some of my favorite stress management activities and tips. Let's go!
After breakfast, I like to do journaling. It just takes me 5 to 10 minutes, yet it makes a huge impact on my day. It helps me set my intentions for the day, and it's very therapeutic for me to let my thoughts flow freely without judgment. I typically follow this format: 3 points each for gratitude, improvement, stress relief, intentions, and affirmations. I also like to plan out my day in the morning. By managing my time and prioritizing tasks, I can achieve a balance between work and relaxation. I highly recommend Notion, an app which I use as a planner and organizer. I also have a Notion page dedicated to school, which has helped me eliminate the pressure of last-minute work. After journaling, I worked out on the elliptical. Exercise is a great way to relieve stress because it increases endorphin production in your body. Endorphins are neurotransmitters that act as a natural pain reliever. Working out also enhances cognitive function. You don't need any fancy equipment to start exercising, as there are a lot of free workout videos online you can follow. Upon finishing my workout, it's important for me to regain my energy. So, I had a very healthy lunch, which was chop suey with brown rice. Believe it or not, I actually love vegetables, especially since I have noticed their positive effects on my physical and mental health. Nutrients from these foods can help improve blood flow in the body, thus improving brain health and reducing cortisol levels. After having lunch, I decided to clean my desk. Clutter can be very stressful, and a messy workspace translates into a cluttered mind. A clean workspace helps me concentrate better on my tasks as my view isn't being overwhelmed by irrelevant things. At around 3 p.m., I meditated. During meditation, I become more mindful, which helps me detach from the anxieties that are crowding my mind. And there are lots of guided meditations online to help you get started. When the midday slump hits, it's good to get moving and change your environment. So, I went on a quick walk outside. It's relaxing to get a breath of fresh air and see the sky, clouds, and trees. After dinner, my friends and I had a virtual movie night through Zoom. I enjoy calling with my friends, especially because we don't get to see each other face to face now. So that concludes my day. It's been a relaxing and productive day, and I'm so happy I got to share it with you guys. Finally, remember that there is no one-size-fits-all when it comes to stress management. So try out different techniques and find what works best for you. Have a wonderful day or night, and I'll see you next time.